Hello and welcome to this course on electronic theory of solids. My name is Arghya Taraphder. I am at the Department of Physics and Center for Theoretical Studies, Indian Institute of Technology, Kharagpur. What I will introduce in this course is a basic understanding of electronic processes that define the properties in a solid. For example, this has become now a core of our understanding of almost all of electronic processes that involve electronic transport, magnetic properties, superconducting properties and their applications, and in energy and in electronics and nowadays in spintronics, for example, and of course also quantum computing, which is coming up. Now, the knowledge of electronic properties of solids is extremely useful for engineers in electronics, electrical engineering, energy applications, and for basic scientists like physicists who are trying to work on condensed matter physics, material science and so on, energy applications, quantum computing and so on and so forth. Now, a prerequisite for this course is of course a basic understanding of quantum mechanics, not a very detailed one, but a basic idea about quantum mechanics, how one uses basic quantum mechanics, and a bit of solid state physics, which is of course at the elementary level. Much of what I will require, I will try to derive, but some understanding would of course help. Now, question is, who can take this course? Almost any material scientist, any person who is trying to understand materials and electronic properties, magnetism, superconductivity and so on, plus electrical engineers, electronics engineers, material scientists, solid state physicists, energy physicists, energy scientists and so on can take this course. Those who intend to work on any of these fields can take this course. And it will certainly benefit them. The syllabus of course is already put up. It starts from a very elementary free electron theory. I will even start from two atoms with two electrons and try to build up the idea of bands, how they form, and the quintessential features of band theory. And then from there on, I will try to derive some basic ideas about a solid, like specific heat and so on. Then we will discuss degenerate electron gas, and beyond the independent electron approximation, whatever happens, actually happens at the level beyond independent electron approximations, and that is what I will discuss in the first few lectures. Then I will come to concept of low dimensional electron gas, a bit of this new idea of quantum dot. Low dimensional means 1 and 2D electron gas and quantum dots, and then if time permits I will also do some integer, at least an idea of what quantum Hall effect is, which is an extraordinarily new and interesting physics that came up in the last 30 years. Then I will discuss magnetism. In magnetism, we will discuss its origin, and many of the applications of solids is in terms of magnetism, through magnetism. So those will be discussed, and we will also discuss what are the elementary concepts that one needs to have to understand magnetic systems, magnetic properties, and the basics of magnetism. Then I will go over to magnetic interactions, for example, because long range order in a magnet, long range magnetic order forms through interactions between moments in a solid, and that involves certain concepts introduced originally by Heisenberg, and then we will go on and discuss those things. Of course, after that comes the famous superconductivity, which is there for more than 100 years with us, and many of the applications nowadays depend on superconductivity. Even medical applications use superconductivity, and superconductivity permeates our life in a big way now. So we will discuss superconductivity. What is superconductivity? How one understands superconductivity, and how does one work with superconductors? So then the basic concepts of superconductivity will be outlined, and then we will discuss the applications like interference junctions, interference techniques, and so on. For example, interferometers using Josephson tunneling have become an extremely important part of the applications of superconductivity, which I will discuss also. Towards the end, I will summarize the concept of electronic properties in solids, and then there I will also outline the upcoming new field of quantum computing, if time permits. And we will, for example, you have seen this quantum supremacy machine being talked about now. So I will discuss at the elementary level, introduce you to such new emerging fields where superconductivity and quantum mechanics have come to play a big role together. Thank you.